dream.
Never seen the Levite house, the righteous forsaken. He didn't say, well, these circumstances, these trials, these things, these issues, so on and so on, and listen, said, no, those are not covered. That would be a man thing. You know, some of us have warranties on things. When you read the small print, it tells you what is not covered. Jesus doesn't have a small print version. It's plain and simple. Never in the world seen the righteous forsaken, nor their seed begging bread. Plain and simple. Don't put no buts in it. Yeah, don't give us no, now you see. It was plain and simple. Never seen. But here's the key word. The righteous. The righteous. The righteous. The righteous. Nor are there seeds begging bread. We're trying to live holy so we can abide, so we can be counted as a righteous. The righteous. The righteous. So I gotta make you sweet. The righteous.
All right, come on.
The righteous. Hallelujah. This is why it says, be ye holy. For what? He said, I am holy. So in other words, if you live a saved, sanctified life, and strive to be like the Lord, then you will be holy and righteous. Because none but the right in the Holy Spirit. None but the in and out of the doors, but the righteous shall see God. None but the righteous. That's why it behooves us to live that which we talk about and profess. It's a lot of people giving lip services. They talk the talk, but they don't work. They don't walk the walk. But I'm just telling you, only good that I do, only what you do for Christ will I. Hallelujah. Send God over your son. Hallelujah. Send God over your son. Hallelujah. Me, Kate, your son. Hallelujah.
Oh,
Lord. Yeah. the Lord that truly come by you.
Oh, yes, we do.
Wherever you are, your home, on a job, riding in your car, on a motorcycle, tricycle, walking, hallelujah, laying in the bed, wherever you are, I know that I want the Lord to stop by. Hallelujah. And I know nobody else can see it, but I was looking up and I just saw a rainbow right up here in this chapter. Hallelujah.
Lord, look at that.
Come by here. Mm-hmm. You may can't see it faster, but I saw it, baby. Look up. Hallelujah. Come by here. And the rainbow was over our mission statement, which so since I saw it, we are going to read it.
Yeah.
Our mission statement is, and the Lord said unto the servant, Go out into the highways and hedges,
Lord,
and compel them to come in.
Tell them
that my house may be filled. Luke 14:23. Hallelujah. That's our job.
Mm-hmm.
To compel them. And you say, well, where are you and who are you? We are Prophetic Outreach Chapel, Cleveland.
Yes.
We are the Mother Chapel and Training Center for the Life Ripples Ministry Global Faith Community. And we are located right here at 3998. East 71st Street, right here at the corner of Indiana Avenue. Cleveland, Ohio, 44105, USA. Hallelujah. Today is prayer Bible service. And we welcome you to it. It's a bit of a lost. My. Hey, hallelujah.
Last chapter.
It's the go bye bye. Set the is the Leviticus 27. And soon as you say, well, the Holy Spirit is in charge. So we have a protocol, but the Lord is the call.
Have your way, Lord.
Hallelujah. Because surely the Lord is in this place called the house of prayer.
Yes, Lord.
Look it up. That's what he said, call this house.
Yes.
The house of prayer.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
All through the Bible.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I don't care what you call your Lord's temple, this, that, hey, chapel, church, so forth. Hallelujah. But it all falls to be what?
House of God.
The house of prayer.
Yeah.
Hey, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Well, the Holy yes, Lord. Thank you. Well, the Holy Spirit takes control.
Mm-hmm.
It's all about you. And I tell you, this is prayer and Bible study. Nevertheless, when the Lord comes in, we come in, he comes in the prayer. We may not get to the Bible study first, but that's okay.
Come in, Lord.
Because the Lord is the one in charge.
Yeah.
So, we've asked the Lord to come by you. Yes, and the Lord. Hey, come out of those sheep, I tell you. We're going to pray the prayer of faith. You know why people are rising with their motorcycles? I hope they're wearing their helmets. The Lord, you know. But we surely don't want to come to have a crash accident without a helmet.
No, we don't.
Hey, tell me about that. No TBIs for our young people. The old people too. Hallelujah.
Old people doing it and young.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
Your name.
Yes, Father the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We have come here, Lord.
Here we are.
In your house.
Yeah.
We have come here today. Seeking you.
Oh, shit, they did.
Seeking you.
Seeking you.
Because, Lord, we need a word from you. So in this lesson, Lord, we ask you to touch today. Touch hearts today.
Touch
minds today. Touch bodies today. Touch souls today. Uplift, Lord, those that are in bereavement. Uplift them, Lord.
Uplift them.
In the name of Jesus. Lord, we know that you are very present help.
Yes, you are.
In the time of trouble.
Oh, yeah.
So here we are, Lord, in whatever state we find ourselves in. Lord, what you know. We know you to be a doctor. We know you to be a lawyer. We know you to be a way maker, heart fixer, problem solver. We know you to do what man thinks is impossible, because nothing is too hard for you. Nothing's impossible for you. You cannot fail.
No.
You cannot fail.
No.
The failure is in us.
Lord God.
But we come to you today. Seeking your forgiveness. Seeking your love.
Yeah.
Lord, because we know we are not perfect, so we ask of you, Lord, to forgive us.
Please.
For everything in us is not like you. Whatever it is, it's not like you. Take it out. Lord, because we want to go higher, Lord. Higher, Lord. Mm. And deeper in your word, Lord. In your word, Lord. Because we ask you, Lord, let the words of our mouth, the meditation of our hearts. The meditations of our hearts. The meditation of our hearts.
Yeah.
Be acceptable in thy sight. Oh, Lord, you are strength today. You are redeemer today. And it's in you, Lord. It's in you and nobody else. It's in you, Lord, that we live, breathe, move, and have our being, Lord. Because, Lord, we are your heir and your children, Lord.
Yes.
Oh, Jesus. We thank you because you're right there making intercession for us.
Oh, right there.
Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
We just want to give you praise because you're talking to your Father. Your Father God. Jesus. You know about the children, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Yes.
So whatever it is, you, Lord, see and you know. Whatever we need, Lord, Lord, you are our provider. Whatever we need, Lord, we know that we can come to you. Because you, Lord, are a very present help. You, Lord, are a place that we have to go. You, Lord, you see about us. Jesus, we know there is power in your name.
Jesus,
we can call on your name and make the devil behave. Jesus, no matter what man says, we know, Lord Jesus, you got the last say. Jesus, you can open the doors that need to be opened.
Yeah.
You can close the doors
that
need to be closed.
Yes.
Jesus, you will work it out. Jesus, we put our hope in you. Jesus, we put our faith in you.
Jesus,
no other help we know. Jesus, we come to you, Lord, and ask for mercy, Lord.
Mercy, Lord.
Because we've already received brand new mercies, Lord. When you woke us up this morning, it was because of your brand
new mercies. Oh, yeah. So Jesus, I just want to thank you right now. Thank you for what you already done. Just want to thank you, Lord, for what you're doing right now. Thank you, Lord, for what you're going to do. Thank you, Lord,
thank you,
for being a child of you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the Holy Spirit that dwells in us. Thank you for the gift. Thank you for the gift. Jesus, 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 we're calling your name. Jesus, Jesus, moved by your spirit. Jesus, I need your help today. Jesus, need your strength today. Jesus, need your deliverance today. Yes, you got that emotion. Lord, yes, Jesus, move on. Yes, Lord, in that situation. Move, Lord. Yes, Lord. Down in the valley, Lord. Move, Lord. Up on the mountaintop. Move, Lord. Yes, Lord. Whatever continent it is. Move by your spirit. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Famine in the land, you're greater than. Wars and rules of wars, you're greater than. You already told us it would be so. Oh God Almighty, you see and you know. We don't have to understand it, but you already foretold us these things will happen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hey, I said I gotta walk on. Hey, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. Yeah, Lord. When you see these things happen, thank you, not strange. Hey, hallelujah.
Thank you, not strange.
Lord, oh, hallelujah. He's already foretold. It's already been prophesied. And prophecy time that rule. And prophecy is being fulfilled right before our eyes. So I'm here to tell you today.
Oh,
you better get ready. Get ready. Get ready. Because I tell you, our Savior, his name is Jesus. Our Savior. His only way back, and by the signs of the time, it's gonna be sooner than later. So you better get your house in order. Yes, you better get your life together. Yes, no time for playing church. No time for just going to be going. You need to get your soul right. Hallelujah. You need to have a talk with Jesus. You need to let him be a friend in thee. Jesus, whatever you need, he's got it. You stop looking to man, because that's not where your help comes.
Definitely not.
Stop looking to technology, because that's not where your help comes. All my help, all your help, comes from the Lord. Yes, I look to the hills from which cometh my strength. My strength is Jesus Christ. My strength is the Father God. Oh, yes, I have faith and trust because he is my creator. And I'm his creation.
I'm yours,
so I know, if he take care of us from all the birds of the air, the animals and the bees, if he take care of them, I know he's going to take care of me, his child. Yes, be not dismayed. my God, your God, will take care of
sure
you.
Enough.
If you only believe, just trust him, hold on to your faith, just trust Jesus, hold on, just trust Jesus, hold on, he's a way maker, if you just trust Jesus, hold on, don't look back to the world, because that's doom and damnation, but only, turn to Jesus, yes, Lord, turn to Yah, yes, Lord, turn to Yahweh, yes, Lord, turn to the Creator, the great that I am, the Alpha and Omega, turn to Him,
which
made us, look to Him, because if you look to the Son, Jesus, if you look to Jesus Christ, the Son of the Most High God, because he got up with all power in his hand.
Got the power.
So you go to Jesus,
where
the power is. Go to Jesus, where his unchanging hand is. Go to Jesus, where he looks on the inside and know what's there. Go to Jesus,
in
the midnight hour.
Jesus.
My very present help in the time of trouble.
Yes,
when I can't go to my wife, I can go to Jesus. When I can't go to my children and great grandchildren, I can go to Jesus. When somebody don't understand, I can go to the rock that's higher than I.
Yeah.
I know he understands. Yes, I can just go to Jesus. Tell him all about my troubles. Go to Jesus.
He's the only one.
Tell them all about my troubles.
He's the only one.
Go to Jesus.
Better go to
and
him.
Tell them all about my
He's
sickness.
The only one.
Go to Jesus.
Yeah.
And cry out to him.
Yeah.
And say, have mercy, Lord. Have mercy, Lord.
Yeah.
Don't know which way to turn. Don't know what's going on. But I know you see. And you know. So I look to you. From which cometh all help. Yes, Lord. I just submit myself to you, Jesus. I just humble myself to you, Jesus. And say, come on in. I need you right now. Come on in. I need to touch. Come on in. I need your healing. Come on in. Deliver me, Lord. Come on in. Save, Lord. Save, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Come on in, Lord. Turn my life around. Come on in, Lord. I want to be made new. Jesus, be a peace all around us. Jesus is a battle axe in the midst of the storm. I am the Lord. Jesus is a way maker. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. See, we got prayers in a prayer box. They're not there for no reason. Because when we give them to Jesus in this prayer box, we have faith. Faith, Lord. And we stand on his promises, and we stand on his word, and we give it to him, and we give it with expectancy. Not with a list, but with expectancy for the Lord to answer.
Answer,
Lord. He may not come. When or how you expect him to come. But he is always on time. He's always on time. He's on time. Don't you know God will do some things that you have to say then when you see it? Oh, I know that was a God moment. I know there was a God thing that just happened in front of me. Don't you know he know how to get our attention and do some movement that we have to confess and admit and acknowledge that God just knew that in my life. That was a God thing right there. That the Holy Spirit came in and he moved. And thank you, Jesus.
Hey.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. If you haven't seen it, you just wait on it. Just wait on it. Because the Lord knows how to work mightily. The Lord knows how to encourage us. The Lord, you know what? You can be kept if you want to be kept. Whoever I'm saying that, though it's hard to say, yeah, okay. But you can be kept if you want to be kept. Young people, well, I just want to do this. No, you can be kept if you want to be kept. There's a lot of things you can do as young people, but you can be kept if you want to be kept. Here's the key. If you keep your minds stayed on Jesus, if you keep your minds stayed on Jesus, if you keep your mind stayed on Jesus, that goes for the old folks too. How about it is, sir, if you want to be kept? Hallelujah. Shalom. Thank you, Jesus. I thank God today. Because I know you're here. I thank God today. Because I know none but God righteous shall see God. I'll play this song and let you go to the rest and get the Leviticus and get the Leviticus. Leviticus. To get this side. Let it go. Give me that shot. Yeah, that was. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus is what? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Now that's something. Worship, thank you. Hallelujah. 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 Think about it.
Let me deep in my despair to show you you would never leave me there. You claim your cousin was made for so much more than ambition. And I'm worth fighting for. Let me with the weight of my mistakes, you carry me and refuse to let me sink under the pressure. You meant for me to soar. I am a child, and I'm worth fighting for. Eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard.
So much more, and so I find.
Wait a minute. wait until the Lord releases you. Because people will push you out on the front and put you on the layers. And when that layers get short and you drop, there are no way to be found.
Nope.
Don't.
They won't be around.
Don't let people pull you out of your place. No. Now they're reducing your calling upon your life. They'll pray for me. They'll pray for me that I do what the Lord is calling me to do to be fasting people daily.
Right way.
Now come on, let's go. Let's do no. Wait on your calling. Be sure. And some people, hot gay people, will see that. I've seen that you are hot, even you are sweet. Some people don't even know they have to go to you. Yes, we can beg the Lord, we can go to know because when the lady had a problem, she went to the priest, she kept bugging him and bugging him and bugging him until finally.
Finally.
He did it.
He took notice.
He said, okay.
Judging.
This woman to you all the time. What is the problem?
Yeah.
What is the problem?
Judging.
What's the problem? But nevertheless, guess what?
Yeah.
The Lord get ready. You got to move.
Oh, yeah.
I'm a witness to that. I try to sit a lot of times. Yeah. But you got to win and make a decision to not to sit there. See, I used to take the time and try to question the Lord. I don't have time these days. Mm-hmm. The Lord just moved me up and I'm out.
Oh,
wow. I'd rather be that way than I'd be saying, well, why, Lord? Come on, maybe I don't make sure it's a movement of the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Because I don't want to do nothing in self, and some of y'all do.
Yeah,
just want to be seen.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I know.
You on that one. See, if that's why you're doing it, well, they're going to see a lot of people in hell.
Oh, yeah.
That's all I have to say. If you're doing things just to be seen,
yeah.
Hallelujah. So we have Leviticus 27.
Huh?
The last day. So I'm going to ask the pastor if you read down, way down.
Way down.
Down to the okay.
See, down to the top.
Down to the Roman. So, if you read down to the 15th verse.
Okay. Okay. Leviticus 27, starting at the first verse. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, speak unto the children of Israel, and say unto them.
What did he say?
When a man shall make a singular vow, the person shall be for the Lord by thy estimation. And thy estimation shall be of the male from 20 years old even unto 60 years old. 20 to 60. Then you can retire.
Thank God for that.
Even thy estimation shall be 50 shekels of silver after the shekel of the sanctuary. And if it be a female, then thy estimation shall be 30 shekels.
Yeah.
If it be from 5 years old, even unto 20 years old, then thy estimation shall be of the male 20 shekels, and for the female 10 shekels. And if it be from a month old, even unto 5 years old, then thy estimation shall be of the male 5 shekels of silver, and for the female thy estimation shall be 3 shekels of silver. And if it be from 60 years old and above, if it be a male, then thy estimation shall be 15 shekels, and for the female, 10. Okay. But if he be poorer than thy estimation, then he shall present himself before the priest. And the priest shall value him according to his ability.
What did you say?
According to his ability.
Whose ability?
The person, the poor people that vowed, shall the priest value him. And if he be a beast, I mean, preachers can value us. And if it be a beast, whereof men bring an offering unto the Lord, all that any man giveth of such unto the Lord shall be holy. Mm-hmm. He shall be holy.
It can be ready.
Nope. Yeah. It'll be holy. Okay. He shall not alter it, nor change it, a good for bad, or a bad for a good. And if he shall at all change beast for beast, then it and the exchange thereof shall be holy. And if it be any unclean beast of which they do not offer a sacrifice unto the Lord, then he shall present the beast before the priest. And the priest shall value it, whether it be good or bad, as thou valuest it. Who art the priest? So shall it be. But if he will at all redeem it, then he shall add a fifth part thereof unto thy estimation.
So if you got to redeem it.
And when a man shall sanctify his house to be holy unto the Lord, then the priest shall estimate it, whether it be good or bad. As the priest shall estimate it, so shall it stand. That's law. And if he that sanctified it will redeem his house, then he shall add the fifth part of the money of thy estimation unto it, and it shall be his.
Okay.
It's saying a lot, huh? Mm-hmm.
And if a man shall sanctify unto the Lord some part of the field of his possession, then thy estimation shall be according to the seed thereof. And homer of barley seed shall be valued at 50 shekels of silver. If he sanctify his field from the year of Jubilee, according to thy estimation, it shall stand.
Yes.
But if he sanctify his field after Jubilee, then the priest shall reckon unto him the money according to the years that remain, even unto the year of Jubilee, and it shall be abated from thy estimation. And if he that sanctified the field will anywise redeem it, then he shall add the fifth part of the money of the estimation unto it, and it shall be assured to him. And if he will not redeem the field, or if he have sold the field to another man, it shall not be redeemed anymore. But the veil, when it goeth out in the Jubilee, shall be holy unto the Lord, as a field devoted. The possession thereof shall be the priest. And if a man sanctify unto the Lord a field which hath bought, which he has bought, which is not of the field of his possession, then the priest shall reckon unto him the worth of thy estimation, even unto the year of Jubilee. And he shall give thy estimation in that day as a holy thing unto the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
In the year of Jubilee, the field shall return unto him of whom it was bought, even to him to whom he possessed the land did belong. And all thy estimation shall be according to the shekel of the sanctuary. 20 garments shall be the shekel.
Mm-hmm.
Only the firstling of the beast, which should be the Lord's. Firstling, no man shall sanctify it, whether it be ox or sheep. It is the Lord's. And if it be an unclean beast, then he shall redeem it according to thy estimation, and shall add a fifth part of it thereunto. For if it be not redeemed, then you shall be sold according to thy estimation. Notwithstanding, no devoted thing that a man shall devote unto the Lord of all that he has, both of man and beast, and of the fields of his possession, shall be sold or redeemed. Every devoted thing is most holy unto the Lord.
Most holy.
None devoted which shall be devoted of men shall be redeemed, but shall surely be put to death.
Mm.
And if, no, not yet. And all thy tithes of the land, whether it be the seed of the land, or the fruit of the tree, is the Lord.
It's the Lord.
It is holy unto the Lord.
All the time.
And if a man will at all redeem aught of his tithes, he shall thereto the fifth part thereof. He shall add thereto the fifth part thereof. And concerning the tithe of the land, tell me right there about tithes.
Yeah.
You say, well, how do you know about God? You know that scripture, but what about these?
They don't even see me.
Mm-hmm. And according to the tithe of the land, of the flock, even of whatsoever passes under the rod, the tenth shall be holy unto the Lord. Notice it said, the tenth shall be holy unto the Lord. He shall not search whether it be good or bad, neither shall he change it. And if he change it at all, then both it and the change thereof shall be holy. It shall not be redeemed. These are the commandments which the Lord commanded Moses for the children of Israel in Mount Sinai. Now, I have the question. Number one, what did the Lord do? What did the Lord do?
Tax the people.
Yeah. According to the scripture, I mean, what did he do?
He gave us some rules concerning the value of a, I guess, the value of a person.
In the first two scriptures.
Yeah, verse 1 and 2.
And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, speak unto the children of Israel, and say unto them, when a man shall make a singular vow, the person shall be for the Lord by thy estimate. So, you're
so it's the vow.
Huh?
is concerning when a person make a vow.
Okay, so, but then the question is, what is
what did the Lord do?
Okay. So, vow, votive offering, a promise to God, also concretely, a thing promised. Wow. Okay, so, you know, you sing a song, may we vow to the Lord, and I won't take you back. That's what it used to say. So they made a vow to the Lord, shall be the Lord's by estimation. So we get into the estimation thing right here.
And that means tax, right?
What?
Estimation is what they're taxed.
Yeah, I'm trying to get there.
Okay.
If I don't want to play. Okay. Order. Role. Estimate. Things that are set in order. Layer. File. Order. Role. Estimate. Valuation. A file. Equipment. Estimate. Equal. Estimation. Things that are set in order. Price. Corporation. Set it off. Suit. Taxation, value. Okay. Want me to go back over that?
That's a lot.
Okay. So the strong definition is a pile, equipment, estimate, equal, estimation. And things that are set in order.
Yeah. Right,
like price, the motivation, set at suit, taxation, and X value. So, whatever the number is for X after that. Okay. Now, so see, we get, I kept hearing about this estimation stuff. What's up with that? What is the estimation? Come on. I can say, I estimate that before long, it's going to be a dollar. Now, I didn't put no time there.
Right.
I just said, you know, I estimate. Well, what are we talking about? What scripture?
3:8. Okay. And thy estimation, verse 3, shall be of the male from 20 years old even unto 60 years old. Even thy estimation shall be 50 shekels of silver after the shekel of the sanctuary. And if it be a female, then thy estimation shall be 30 shekels. And if it be from 5 years old even unto 20 years old, then thy estimation shall be of the male 20 shekels, and for the female 10 shekels. And if it be from a month old even unto 5 years old, then thy estimation shall be of the male 5 shekels of silver, and for the female thy estimation shall be 3 shekels of silver. And if it be from 60 years old and above, if it be a male, then thy estimation shall be 15 shekels, and for the female, 10 shekels. But if he be poorer than thy estimation, then he shall present himself before the priest, and the priest shall value him according to his ability. That vow shall the priest value him.
Okay. In this scripture, the line, who is most valuable?
The men.
The men are most valuable. What is cut off for that?
Because they can work.
Yeah, okay, so what age is it from 20 to what?
60.
And after 60, they can retire.
Yeah.
Okay, you should not be taxed. So.
Yeah.
And the women from that age were more valuable than the older one.
Yeah.
But we learned here, the men were the most valuable.
Amen.
Well, but what if you got a man that's just born? Can't do the work. So in that house, who's more valuable? The man or the woman?
Or the children.
Well, I'm just insisting there's no children. The man and the woman.
The man. The female.
Would be of more value than him.
Right.
But
you still had to go to the priest and he would have to evaluate you.
Okay. So in modern day things, when we get hurt or whatever, we retire.
Yeah.
We have to go to some authority.
Yes.
To be deemed the retirement age.
Social Security.
Be deemed unemployable.
Yeah.
But deemed totally disabled.
Mm-hmm.
So, in the same principle, they do go to the priest. So, because if the man can't work and do anything, then according to that, he should have to pay the 50 shekels.
Right.
He had to pay according to his ability.
That's it.
And his ability is that I can't do nothing. Okay. You pay one shekel.
You get a do nothing price.
Right. You know, and then, you know, one shekel. And then it's far to be, if you kind of do it like that.
Wait a minute, where does it say 60 and up? Where is that at?
You know, yeah, but. It's 15 shekels.
60 years old and above would be for a male. So that would be 15 probably and under.
So, once the priest said, let's just say, because of this type of injury that you have, you only have to pay one shekel.
Right.
So that, in essence, starts to set the standard.
Right.
Because if you come with this type of disability, we already know the price we are going to value at one shekel. There's no point in taxing you when you are not able to produce.
And that's fair.
And you come in there with, say, they have the ability to, I can sweep out. I can sweep. And you might say, yeah, I don't know how that is. Something that can't be valued, you know. And you might say to them, no, you can sweep. You can't. You might not fall in this category of that you poorer than the estimation, because sweeping is a job.
Yeah, it is.
You ought to be able to make those 15 shekels. So, you know, he's like the priest that had to, you know, divide.
Power to do that.
And I will say that as the priest, I hope that the anointing is there to give him wisdom so he'll be able to discern the fakers from the deserving.
He will.
But I'm just saying, in this case, he already did it. Because, you know, in every society, there's always some schemers.
Oh, yeah.
So this is an interesting question. Question number four, why a house? Let me know. What's a vow? What's that about?
Well,
what scriptures?
9-13.
Yes. Okay. Read.
And if it be a beast, whereof men bring an offering unto the Lord, all that any man giveth of such unto the Lord shall be holy.
Hold it right there. So what are they bringing? The offering, what are they bringing to the Lord? The key word here.
Offering.
So they're bringing the offering. So now everybody needs to see this. It's an offering that people have, that people will give to the Lord.
Right.
It's not a man made up thing.
No, it's not.
Okay, let's continue.
He shall not alter it nor change it. a good for a bad, or a bad for a good. And if each shall it all change beast for beast, then it and the exchange thereof shall be holy. And if it be any unclean beast of which they do not offer a sacrifice unto the Lord, then he shall present the beast before the priest. And the priest shall value it, whether it be good or bad, as thou values it, who art the priest, so shall it be. Mm-hmm. But if he will at all redeem it, then he shall add a fifth part thereof unto thy estimation.
Okay. Here again, let's look at what they're saying.
Yeah.
To redeem, act as kinsmen, redeemer. Avenge, reverse, avenge, revenge, ransom, do the part of a kinsman. To act as a kinsman, do the part of the next of kin, act as a kinsman. Okay. By marrying the brother's widow, to get a child for him, to redeem from slavery, to redeem land, to exact vengeance, to redeem by payments, to redeem with God as the subject, individuals from death, Israel from Egypt, bondage, Israel from exile, to redeem oneself, to be redeemed. Mm. I keep using the word, it's funny, but according to the Oriental law of kinship, that is, to be the next of kin, as such, to buy back a relative property, marry his widow, etc.
Yeah.
Avenge, deliver, to perform the part near, next to.
Like Boaz did.
Huh?
Like Boaz did.
Yeah. Man, purchase, ransom, redeem. So, so he had to make good.
Mm-hmm.
So in other words, I think he said, this is bad. The preacher said, no, this is bad. Mm-hmm. And you know this is bad.
Yeah.
So, no, the value of this is zero.
Right.
Take this back. And I would think, though, if you saying the priest. Now, the priest have a lot of duties to do.
Yes.
So, I'm taking it that there's more than one priest.
Well, they were, because, you know, they all were in the house. It was all those... other than Aaron's sons, see
the Levites,
and the ones assigned to the duty of the house.
Right. But that's what I'm saying. It
now,
all these duties,
all those duties lay on the state now.
Yeah. But back then,
the priests had to do all that.
Okay. But if he will at all redeem it, then he shall add a fifth part thereof unto that estimation. So, you were really held by your wife. You can't say, I'm going to do this. And then don't do it.
But then you got to add a fifth part to it if you didn't.
Yeah, so, you might as well do it.
Yeah.
Because there is a punishment.
Yeah.
And like, if you don't do it, okay, so now you want to do it, but now it's going to cost you.
You know what? That's interest, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
That's where they get that from.
Oh, yeah.
IRS.
Yeah, the usury.
Yeah, usury. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Okay. What happens today? You say, I made a vow to the Lord. And you know how we do.
Mm-hmm.
We get in a situation and we say, Lord, if you do X, Y, and Z, then I do A, B, C.
Right.
Because you're in a title. Then the Lord, knowing that you're not going to do A, B, C, does X, Y, and Z. And then you go on about your business like it never happened. Somewhere down the line, I believe that there is accountability. You won't have to pay.
It should be.
Down the line, And maybe, I don't know, if maybe you have, you know, been telling people about holes in that pocket and all that kind of stuff. But maybe you didn't do ABC like you said, and they come to a point when you find yourself, I'm in a situation, and maybe the Lord reminds you, yeah, because you told me you're going to do ABC.
Yeah.
Now here you are in this situation because
you didn't do it.
So you can't come back and tell me you're going to do A, B, and C. That's not going to work this time.
No. And you know what? You got to hold them accountable. You got to tell them. I know when people come to me and they ask me, they say, well, it's hard for me to pay my taxes. I got all these bills and stuff like that. I just tell them, you still owe God. It's still his part. You still owe it. Now, you may not pay it this time, but you got to catch up. You know, you still got to do it. Somebody got to remind them.
Well, here's the thing.
I know he don't want to hear it.
I would say to this, to those people who are listening, and I don't know about other countries, but I was taught that even if you're on a fixed income,
right,
it's still his money.
That's his money, a tenth.
So you're supposed to still tithe. You're supposed to give offerings.
Yes.
That's why people are blessed. And then you don't do it, you'll end up costing you more than if you were just into tithes and offerings.
Yes.
And here's what people need to understand. I'm trying to stay focused. Is that bring me all the tithes and offerings to the storehouse. And say, well, you're supposed to be able to go back and get that if you need it. Well, here's the thing.
It doesn't say that.
Here's the thing. Even if that was the case, and someone comes, has not paid their tithes and offering, but they're in a situation, we, as the saints, supposed to go in that storehouse
and help them.
And help them out. Not say, well, no, they didn't pay their tithes and their offering. No. That was laid up because we need to help them.
Right.
We don't know
who.
Because one day it could be us.
Right.
And we had to go to the storehouse. Don't be too proud. I don't have any food. This, that, and the other. That's it. Come get it.
If I'm hungry, I'm going to get a can of soup off that shelf.
No, come get it.
That's right.
Then, if we do that, the Lord will bless us and keep increasing that.
Yeah.
If we don't do it, it'll go back.
Yeah.
But that's what it's for.
Mm-hmm.
It does not. Now, here, some of this stuff went to the priest.
Yeah.
Tithes and offering. If everybody would pay the tithes and offering, I'm just going to be frank.
It wouldn't be no problem.
Then all the bills of every house of worship
would be met.
Would be met.
Oh, yeah. More than enough.
Would be in the struggling. And then you take the other part and do the other mission and work that the Lord gives us to do.
Yes.
You know, and if the pastor gets to the point where he's in need or she's in need,
it's there.
Yes.
Yeah. He live off the house.
But that's what should have happened.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to know why you have some people that have all these magnificent buildings laid up for the Lord. And people pay their tithes and offering and keep it going. And you have little chapels. And people say, I'm not doing that.
They won't do it either.
I'm not paying the offering. If I have it, I give it. Let me change. You yourself change. Well, if I'm paying my offering, I don't need tithes, because tithes for the pastor. No, no, no.
No, they not. He gets his part.
If the pastor rise up, and I know this is happening, in a new car, if they have worked a job,
oh my goodness,
or working a job,
and paying their notes,
you are not paying their notes.
No.
They worked for that.
Yes, they did.
Or they're working for that. But some of us get confused and twisted and say, well, that's my time. No, no. The tithes belong to the Lord.
That niggas can't pay for no pastor's car.
And, you know, it takes lights, support, taxes. It takes a lot in these days.
Mm. It's more than been put in.
Than to take to run a house of worship.
Oh,
in
yeah.
their day, those days, they didn't have to worry about any of that.
No, they didn't, because it was provided.
Right. And the priest didn't have to worry about feeding their families, because
no.
the Lord provided for them.
Yes, he did.
So, why a house?
Because they don't believe the word of God, I'm going to tell you.
Yeah, okay. Why a house? So, where did you get the answers from?
Oh. I put down 14 to 18.
Nope. 14 to 15.
Okay.
And when a man shall sanctify his house.
Okay.
To be holy unto the Lord. Mm-hmm. Then the priest shall estimate it, whether it be good or bad, as the priest shall estimate it, so shall it stand. And if that sanctified it will redeem his house, then he shall add the fifth part of the money of thy estimate unto it, and it shall be his.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I was reading this part,
mm-hmm.
and I was thinking about, you know, where it came from. You know, when people get houses and their apartments, mm-hmm. what do they have to do? They want the pastor to come and do what?
Bless it.
Bless it.
Mm-hmm.
Here we are right here.
Yeah.
Come and bless it.
Come and bless it.
So, but if we came and saw that you had a fine house and said, well, your house is worth $500,000,
mm-hmm.
and that's what you owe to and get tied to, you know, most of the pastors probably wouldn't live. And they would say that right there in the spot. I mean, like, what you coming, you taxing me? So, and in some churches, in some faith community, you know, you have, when you join,
mm-hmm.
you, it's like filling out an application for work.
Yeah.
You have to put down what your income is.
It does.
And then all of that stuff they put in, so they know what you're supposed to be tithing.
And that's right.
They know based upon what you should be paying an offering. And I believe they get some people, most of them give out envelopes so they can track what's going on.
And in actuality, they're right. Even though we don't like it, but.
Well, I don't think it's part of me being a member of a faith community, I got to go in and put out all this. The 40 question application. That's part of being a new member orientation.
Mm-hmm. Well, how are you going to get the estimation of what a person is worth if they don't fill out the application?
Because we said people come to jail.
Okay.
And I stress to people, the Lord giveth.
Mm-hmm.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. So, if you're living in a fancy house,
mm-hmm.
and you're coming in as a pauper, God sees that and knows that too.
Mm-hmm.
If you're coming in driving your fancy, because I've seen this in your fancy car,
mm-hmm.
but your house is a shack. Okay, God knows that too.
Yeah.
And some people have fancy cars, and guess what? They don't have no house, they have to live in that car. You don't know.
Yeah.
So, if they give it a tenth right. unto the Lord in tithes,
God is pleased.
Right. If they give their free will offering,
mm-hmm.
and nobody should have beat you on the head, that's why here you don't do offering once. You don't say, I got $2.55. Okay, we get better than that and send it to them. If that's what you're blessed with, that's what we have.
Yeah.
Because the Lord sees and knows and is blessed.
Mm-hmm.
But if you got a big house and a big car, and you don't fight the things over there and everything else, and everybody knows what you have, and you come to church and you give $5. It looks like it. Okay, that's your offering. $5. Now, are you cheating God? Or you come and say, my tithe is $5, and we have 50 cents for offering.
That's not right.
Now, God is seeing all of that.
Mm-hmm.
We don't know what your circumstances are, but God knows that.
He knows.
So, you know, if you're giving, freely giving unto the Lord, that which is within your offering, and that which is within your tithes, you will be blessed.
Yeah.
You said, try me and see. There again, it's a call out. Try me.
Oh, yeah.
Try me and see.
Yeah.
See, when I what? Open up the windows of heaven.
He was showing up here.
Okay. Question number 5. What redemption are they talking about? What's going on here?
16 to 47.
Yes.
Okay. And if a man shall sanctify unto the Lord some part of or field of his possession, then thy estimation shall be according to the seed thereof, and omer of the barley seed shall be valued at 50 shekels of silver. Okay. If he sanctify his field from the year of Jubilee, according to thy estimation, it shall stand. But if he sanctify his field after the Jubilee, then the priest shall reckon unto him the money according to the years that remain, even unto the year of the Jubilee, and it shall be abated from thy estimation. And if he that sanctified the field will in any wise redeem it, then he shall add the fifth part of the money of thy estimation unto it, and it shall be assured to him. And if he would not redeem the field, or if he have sold the field to another man, it shall not be redeemed any more. But the field, when it goes out in Jubilee, shall be holy unto the Lord, as a field devoted. The possession thereof shall be the priest. And if a man sanctify unto the Lord a field which he hath brought, which is not of the fields of his possession, then the priest shall reckon unto him the worth of thy estimation, even unto the year of Jubilee, and he shall give thine estimation in that day as a holy thing unto the Lord. In the year of the Jubilee, the field shall return unto him of whom it was bought, even to him whom the possession of the land did belong. And all thy estimation shall be according to the shekel of the sanctuary. 20 gerahs shall be the shekel. Only the firstling of the beast, which should be the Lord's firstling, no man shall sanctify it, whether it be ox or sheep, it is the Lord's.
Okay.
And if it be an unclean beast, then he shall redeem it according to thine estimation, and shall add a fifth part of it thereto. Or if it be not redeemed, then it shall be sold according to thy estimation. So yeah. I'm looking at this as all have to do with the Jubilee.
Yeah. So the word, girth.
Mm-hmm.
Where girth is, girth and weight of 20 part of a shekel,
mm-hmm,
equal to the weight of 16 barley grains, or 4 to 5 power beans.
Mm-hmm.
So
you can bargain. Parking,
right.
If you don't have money, then you can use the Gerald's, or what's the other one you said?
I forgot, but I'm going to tell you what it is. Gerald or small weight,
mm-hmm,
and corn.
Okay.
So think about it as a coin.
All right.
Size. Now, So think of it, it's all about the Jubilee.
Mm-hmm.
But it is, and everything has to return, you know, with the Jubilee coming. But everything is given, just taxed based upon how it can be used.
Right.
Because if the man bought the land and didn't do anything with it, then he's still going to be taxed.
Oh, yeah.
Based upon the land. And if you sold it to somebody and didn't do anything with it, that's still on you. Because the Jubilee is going to come right back to you.
Yes.
If you sold it and the man who possessed it did great things, the sanctified and all that, if the Jubilee comes, it's time for that land. It got to go back to you.
Got to go back.
So, to me, when things turn back, that to me is the redemption part. Because it's being turned back. And when you don't do the thing that you're supposed to do with it, you got to pay.
Yeah.
So that's making it right.
Yeah. Or if something happened where somebody died or something, that owed that property.
Yeah. You take it over.
Mm-hmm.
Or if there's a lien on it, you pay the money.
Yeah.
And then what's the money? Okay, what can or cannot be redeemed? That's just it. What can or cannot be redeemed?
Okay, that's 28 and 29?
Yes, ma'am. Notwithstanding, no devoted thing.
No devoted thing.
That a man shall devote unto the Lord of all that he has, both man and beast of the field of his possession shall be sold or redeemed. Every devoted thing is most holy unto the Lord. None devoted which shall be devoted of men shall be redeemed, but shall surely be put to death. None devoted which shall be devoted of men shall be redeemed, but shall be surely be put to death.
This thing belongs to the Lord.
And what happens if that happens today, see?
Mm.
Okay. What
are
you talking about? Come on.
Now. So that word devoted is that the same thing as set apart?
Yes. But now look over here. You get to a sin. I'll be going. Hold on. Give you what you say.
Okay.
Okay. The word to describe a devoted thing.
Yeah.
Dedicated.
Okay, dedicated.
Band. Devotion. Okay. And that thing perforated. Have been utterly destroyed. Appointed to.
Mm-hmm.
Other destruction.
Appointed.
The strong definition. Physically and shutting in a net. Either literally or figuratively, usually a doomed object, abstracted extermination, cursed, dedicated thing, that which should have been utterly destroyed, appointed to other destruction in the world effect.
Wow.
That book like this.
I mean, that's
what that. You might not be devoting no statue.
Okay.
Yeah. Because you and it will be destroyed.
Sure enough.
So, but it's this time thing, you know. What if, okay, if I'm giving all the. What are you talking about? Tithing? What?
What tithes are they talking about?
Explain to me about tithing, because maybe I don't feel like that's necessary.
Well, here it is. It's like a, it's more explanation about tithing. 30 to 34. It breaks it down. Oh, 30. And all the tithe of the land, whether of the seed of the land or of the fruit of the tree, is the Lord's. It is holy unto the Lord.
Holy.
Mm-hmm. And if a man will at all redeem all of his tithes, he shall add thereto the fifth part thereof. And concerning the tithe of the herd or of the flock, or even of whatsoever passes under the rod, the tenth shall be holy unto the Lord.
Holy unto the Lord.
Mm-hmm. He shall not search whether it be good or bad. Don't question it. Neither shall you change it. And if he changes it all, then both it and the change thereof shall be holy. It shall not be redeemed.
Okay.
These are the commandments which the Lord commanded Moses for the children of Israel in Mount Sinai.
But I'm not a child. That doesn't fit me. That's just for those people. He does not have an inclusivist. He's just talking about the Israelites, of which I am not.
But if it belongs to the Lord, then it concerns more than just one group of people. Because
he just said all what they were talking about belongs to him. I don't see anything about anybody else.
It says the land, it belongs to the Lord.
Okay.
It said it's the Lord. So if it's his, that means he created it. He's in charge of it. So.
But we're talking about the Israelites and where they were, their land.
No, you can't separate the land. The land, because the land is everywhere.
Well, but. He was specifically talking to the Jewish people. So wherever they were, that's for them. How can that be applicable to me? I'm not Jewish.
But you're living on his land. You're drinking his water and eating his animals.
Yeah, but I am not over there where the Jewish people were traveling. This was a commandment given to Moses for the children of Israel in Mount Sinai.
It said, whatsoever passes under the rod, the tempter, be holy unto the Lord.
Okay.
And it said, don't search whether it be good or bad. Don't change it. Don't alter it. Don't redeem it. Don't discuss it.
Okay, but do you see me walking around with a rod? therefore, again, that is for the children of Israel. Are you walking around with a rod?
No.
So I'm saying.
Unfortunately, I don't have a rod.
I'm just saying. it's talking about them. Mm-hmm.
No, it applies to me.
You're an Israelite?
If I'm circumcised in the heart, I'm an Israelite. Because Israelites are those that are circumcised in the heart.
Well, yeah.
According to the word.
Now, you see. But the here. Is clearly talking about these folks that probably were not circumcised at the heart.
Right.
They were literally circumcised. And keeping the vow between them and the Lord.
So you're saying other people don't have to tithe?
I'm just saying.
If they're not Israelites?
Well, I'm just saying. I'm not Israelite. Yeah. Well, I got to even give free offerings and tithe. Yeah. That's too much. How about I could just give offerings
But if you're not an Israelite, you don't have to do any of it, right? You don't even have to give offering.
I rest my case.
No, I'm saying if so, you're not an Israelite, so that means you not even have to give an offering.
This is what I'm talking about. I'm not giving an offering. I don't have to do tithe. That's what I'm saying. I'm not.
So that means you're not an Israelite and you don't belong to God.
Right, but you're saying that only Israelites belong to God. I didn't see that in there.
They were his chosen people.
Okay, so
at this time.
And you're saying that they were in the house after them?
Not then.
Okay, then. Mm-hmm. You do it. So, since this was really just talking specifically to Israelites, then I feel that we should listen.
Okay. Now, what about the tithes?
In the offer. Well, we have to say right there though, who he was speaking to. And I just say this, look at Israel, look at the Jewish houses of worship.
Oh my.
Okay. I'm just saying. Look at the other houses of worship. I'm just saying. Some people got manuals, some people got computers. So if I'm looking at this, I say, well, I'm not looking at it. That's my great excuse. No time and no offer. I'm good. Can I say that?
I don't think so. Mm-hmm.
You don't think so. Mm-hmm. So, this lesson is for understanding about the Bible, understanding about redemption, understanding about the priest to value people, things, and abilities, and that offerings are expected, as well as tithes are expected.
Even if they're not Jewish?
Yeah. I don't know in this circumstance. But I'm just saying, if you just take it just for the Jewish people in this question, I'm going to leave you here hanging out. Yes, just say, look, all I'm saying is, all I'm saying to the people, saints and friends, look at the Jewish houses of worship.
And how they're blessed.
And all the other centers and everything attached to the other houses of worship. Now start looking at other houses of worship. Maybe in these other houses of worship, people may not believe in giving them offerings, real offerings, or tithes.
Right.
So consequently, you contrast and compare, look at their languages and look at ours. So when you come in and say, well, why is this? Why do we like this? Well,
it's your fault.
I said, I'm going to leave you hanging. I'm just saying.
I'm going to say, put
them
in the blame
here.
It's your fault.
I'm just saying. Look at the other. How do the worship?
Because even with the lesson that we had about David, he wasn't satisfied how the heart was. But then he set aside money and things so that it could be built, even though he wasn't able to build it, but he set aside finance for it.
Okay, he set aside finance for it. Mm-hmm. So we're saying that there was tithes and offerings set up in the storehouse.
Set up in the storehouse.
But
Because if you don't put anything in the storehouse, then you won't get anything. Mm-hmm. You'll have like the baby. If you come in, you see, you get what you get. Because you haven't contributed.
Right, especially in the small house of worship. You come in and say, well, why is this like this? And what if the Lord said, because you didn't tithe, your tithes are often.
Right.
What do you mean, why is it like this? Come in, oh, we don't have no lights on. And if the echo, of course, should say, because you all have not been paying your tithes or often. What
right.
do you expect?
What do you expect? Bring your flashlight.
Okay, oh, we're coming in now. Well, we can't use the whole facility?
No,
because the heat bill is $2,000. Well, why is it so high? And it wasn't the board said, because you haven't been paying your tithes. Why is the pastor and priest, whatever, sitting in the hospital? Because you don't worry them to death for them trying to figure out how to take their money and pay.
House and church.
Yeah, right. So they just worried them to death because, and almost to the point of death because they can't do it.
No, they can't do it.
Well, they come to church one day, why is it closed up? And it's closed. Because the pastor just walked away. It was tired. Same with the people. Mm-hmm. Can't do it anymore. Well, why you can't do it anymore? When it was open, what was he doing? What? Well, he out there on the street corner preaching. Yeah, right. He's out there on the street corner preaching.
I mean, you should be out there too.
Right. What are you doing?
Yeah.
Well, why? Well, this is telling me. Why?
Mm-hmm.
I don't care if your tithe was 10 cents.
Hey.
And your offering was a penny. You're doing your best. Then, you know, the Lord says, try me.
Mm-hmm.
So your 10 cent tithe could be equivalent to $1 million.
Well, it's mine.
And your penny offering could be considered $1,000. Because you gave all, you gave what you had.
The goodness of your life.
What if somebody else, that I knew you had, and they give, say, $10 for your one penny?
Mm-hmm.
They pay tithes, they pay $100 in tithes to match your what? 10. But one, they give them aggressively, and two, it's not 10%.
Mm-hmm.
Whose offer is greater? The one that gave from their heart.
Mm-hmm.
And took it off the top.
Yeah.
Okay. I want to be late, but I'm saying, you look, I was taught, don't pay everything else first, and then give
no.
the Lord the leftover.
Don't do that. But you never have enough.
Because you shortchanging the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And there were two couples in the Bible. They tried to shortchange the Lord. And let's just say that's when Undertaker really came into being.
See, that's his money.
They sit up there on the tent and don't want to give God back what's due to him out of his money.
A tenth.
And they came and they tried to perpetrate fraud. Mm-hmm. And boom! Dead.
Yeah.
Undertakers had to come get him and drag him out. And guess what? They had no funeral. They took him out and buried him right then and there.
Johnny on the spot.
Then here comes the wife.
Cool.
Because she ain't heard about what happened to her husband.
No, but her husband's mess.
She gonna come with the same fraud.
Mm-hmm.
And guess what? Boom! Dead.
Yeah.
He come to Undertakers. And bury her right next to her husband.
Oh,
okay,
yeah.
That was it. No funeral, no nothing. You dead, gone, buried. Oops.
Well, at least they together.
but you live in infamy because now everybody around know
fear
what you did.
Yeah.
So that's your legacy because you try to defraud the one who gave you that which you had in the first place.
Didn't have to do it.
And boom. And that is okay. I'm going to stop. I'll go over there. Yes. And the one who went to the Father's tent, it was an idolater. He decided because they were getting ready to leave their country, their family, they'd take one little idol with them. And guess what? Things just stopped not working out like it's supposed to work out.
Right.
So finally they said, look, okay, let's just stop. The Lord has not said, Now who would have brought the idols to be now? You're trying to get us cursed. No. They will stop. And guess what? They will find out. You're gonna sneak and get yourself out because you're still trying to be an idolater. Idolater when you're supposed to be serving the
one and true God,
but you still got something. And it didn't work out.
No.
And then you were found out. And that didn't work out for you neither.
Definitely swallowed them in the hole.
So
if
it wasn't for the mercy of Jesus, we probably still have those same things. So I'm going to close with this. This song is going up. What if you came and didn't do what you were supposed to do inside of the Lord? And the chair you were sitting in, all of a sudden the hole opened up, and you and the chair went there, and the whole closed up.
Oh, my Lord.
You were sitting in a chair in the church. Mm-hmm. No, you was that big XYZ. You didn't do it, and you're trying to defraud him, and the door just opened up and swallow you and then hold and close it back up.
And everybody watching.
Right. You said that don't happen. Well, go back and look at some news clippings or some videos where they have had houses just swallowed up. Mm-hmm. People get in their bed. And just got swallowed up, never to be seen more again.
Sure enough.
Sinkholes, they're called.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, don't be walking into it, making a sinkhole for your own self. Oops.
This is still happening.
You saying what that is? Yeah, it's a sinkhole. You can get in a spiritual sinkhole.
You don't want to get in no sinkhole.
No.
In the air, either.
Happening in the air. Yeah. Getting true. Hey, how ya? Hey, how ya, Rosa?
Glory to God.
Hey, Rosa. Wow, mom, how did that?
Thank you, Lord.
Say, come on, and then he sees the door of a horse. Neither is it. Oh, my, did say, ha, sure, me, sir, of a oh, he under the ass. Hey, hey,
thank you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Yeah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.